Wherever I travel, I always look for Chinese restaurants. I know that not only will I get delicious Chinese food, but inside every restaurant, I will discover a personal story, a unique story of courage, survival, and hope. Dawn, Fat Tuesday, Mardi Gras, the day of the big carnival parade in Trinidad, Tobago. The constant sound of the calypso beat reverberates over the valley. I arrived late last night, and I have only had 4 hours sleep. The sun has not yet risen, but the party is in full swing. I'm meeting Anna Soong and her husband, Johnny Johnston. We will drive into Port of Spain, the capital, to take part in the masquerade, or to play mass, as they say on the island.
The year is 2010, my vision is bold. National unity finally take hold. Shed Barat as Prime Minister, come along, my friend. Today with you, Trinidad.
There's
plenty changes in the ordinary. Shock control, Trinidad and Tobago. No more red house in Port of Spain. Is in yellow, it now prevail. And if you sin and when you pray, you could make a jail. There's plenty changes in the
Anna Soong has invited me to come to Carnival and to check out her father's restaurant in San Fernando. People have told me that Soong's Great Wall serves the best Chinese food in the Caribbean, and the Wednesday night buffet is legendary. But, in fact, I'm less interested in the food than I am in finding out how Anna's father, Maurice Soong, came from China to live on this island.
Chinese food is very difficult. Not like English food, you soup. Say you want a steak, you one plate, and you die. And Chinese menu, they don't have 100 things. All they say, I like to have some shrimps, I like to have some roastduck, I like to have some steamed fish also. You will have the experience to serve how many food will enough for, say, 6 or 10 people.
Maurice Soong insists that his restaurant has class. He trains his staff in a professional manner, and his food is served in the proper way. The Great Wall has become a school for restaurant management on the island. Parents entrust their children to Maurice so that he can groom them. When he takes me into the kitchen, I am frankly amazed. It's one of the cleanest Chinese kitchen I've ever seen.
Hello.
The food. Ah, yes, the food. I have the most delicious roast duck this side of the Pacific, prepared by chefs hired directly from Maurice's native village in China and barbecued in a Chinese rotisserie imported from Miami.
Cooking from very young, yeah, I was 12 years old, I started to cook. Yeah, my father is a good cook too. He teach me and I cook. And I like to eat a lot, so that's why I think my aim is to go in restaurant business. I came to Trinidad in 1948. It took me 20 days in the boat from Hong Kong to San Francisco, and then 2 days by plane to reach Trinidad. When I reached Trinidad, and what I saw, everything was different.
Chinese men of his generation, Maurice Soong's father left his wife and children behind to escape poverty at home and to seek a better life in the Americas. He came to Trinidad to join a relative who was running a small general store in a village called Hermitage. Some years later, he sent for Maurice.
The first time I met my father, right? I didn't know that's my father. We came face to face. And he said, son, I'm your father. I didn't know my father because my father left China for Trinidad. I was only 3 years old.
Young men from China joined their fathers and uncles in the Americas to help out in stores, laundries, and restaurants. When they were old enough to get married, they were sent back to China to find wives who would bear them children. Many women stay behind in China while their husbands continue with their lives in the Americas. I am curious about the life of these men so far from home. I try to get a sense of this by asking Maurice if he knew whether his father had another family here.
He have a happy life, so to say.
How many children does he have with other women?
Well, I don't think he have any children, but he claim he have one son, which I know too, right? He claim that he's his son, but I never, yeah.
Does your mother know that he has other women?
Yeah, my mother knew. The other woman also come in the business place sometime too. But the lady is very good.
Maurice seems a little evasive. I'm not sure what he really knows about his father's life before his mother arrived. The family was finally reunited 9 years after Maurice came to Trinidad.
I don't know my father, so I only know my mother. Until I come to Trinidad. So naturally, I feel very happy. I'm very close to my mother.
Did you miss your mother?
Yeah, I miss my mother.
When they said you miss your mother, you cried.
Every time I at home, my mother cried.
It was his mother who held the family together as Maurice transformed his life, going from humble shopkeeper to successful restaurateur. A lot of credit also goes to his first teacher in Trinidad, Miss Noel. Miss Noel, who's now Mrs. Chador, still lives near San Fernando. And Maurice takes me to visit her and the school where he started his new life.
Chateau, you know Miss Chateau?
You go straight across. I'm on the right hand side as you cross the road, that corner house.
Okay. Get it. This is my teacher, my master. My teacher.
How old were you when Maurice first came?
About, let me see, could be 24, 25. I could have been 24, 25, about that age. Because
my first year at school, I don't even know ABC. So, Miss Noel, that is a teacher, she took me to school, and she told me, I sit down near to she, so she could give me personal attention.
We used to have the school garden here. Now they have built all the toilet facilities.
So this was the first school that
Maurice
came?
Yes,
yes.
This
school.
Is where you first learned ABC?
ABC. After the school,
you went?
Miss Chateau come home, I mean.
Then I work, you know, help him on evenings. It was better because we had good times. We used to play cricket in the shop, you remember?
When I come to school, I sit down.
Well,
that's it. You sit down together.
Well, you see, because it's only so I'd be able to talk with him and explain to him, and not with all the children. He has always shown gratitude to all those who have helped him where he worked, where he lived in Hermitage, and me, myself in particular. And also, he has done it very simply, with all humility, no show, no fashion or anything, no kind of boast or anything. And he continued to maintain this up to today. And his business, as far as I see it, because of that, people go to Soong's Great Wall. Now he has also tried to maintain and upkeep a decent and clean business.
Chinese came to Trinidad first as indentured laborers in plantations, and later as merchants and shopkeepers. All over the island, in every little village, there was always a Chinese shop.
No, I don't think.
Maurice takes us to visit what had been his father's shop near the school.
When I came from China in 1948, I landed in here. It was a wooden structure. We sell foodstuff, clothes, and everything you can find. Anything, you have a license to sell liquor, scotch, rum, wine, you sell for stuff, clothing, needle thread, bicycle parts, everything.
Okay.
Maurice and his wife grew up in the same village in China. Set up and encouraged by her parents, Brenda came to Trinidad to meet Maurice in the 60s. Her mother and father were hopeful that she would like him enough to marry and settle in Trinidad. Brenda, of course, had no idea where Trinidad was, and when she got here in 1964, she found it even more primitive and backwards than her native Hong Kong.
我媽媽認識到佢媽媽嘅，即係咁樣又我有啲uncle又喺Trinidad介紹嘅，咁同我媽咪傾啊咁樣，嗰陣時我媽咪啊就講俾我老豆知，佢話好啊咁樣，香港而家都啲環境咁鬼都冇用嘅香港，嗰陣時香港真係冇用啊，60年代嗰陣時，咁係咁樣而家係咁樣出到外國嘅啫嘛。
When I went to the airport to meet her, it surprised me, you know. That time, when she young, small, in the school, I know her. But now she grew up, I watch her, I say she changed very much. She's so beautiful.
One afternoon, Maurice takes me to Charlotte Street, Port of Spain's Chinatown. I can see for myself that Chinese Trinidadians have come a long way from running Chinese shops and mini markets in the villages. Today, it's food emporiums and supermarket chains in the city.
Entire crew in just a little bit. Also later on in this hour, although he cut the title of Road March King, Subaru says his heart goes out to Iwer. We're going to give you details of that and more in the next hour right here at 96.1 WEFM. It's Maximum Drive Time.
Hey! This one you must have a dance in front of you. For someone to remind you, give me an album seat. Jeff Mack, album seat. Watch it. Watch it. Come on. Hey, 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 hey. What?
I come inside the party. It's Bacchanal.
Maurice and Brenda have three daughters and one son. Even though it is traditional in Chinese culture for the son to take over his father's business, Johnny Soong did not follow his father's footsteps. Instead, he has branched out into an even more lucrative business and has become an impresario in the island's music and entertainment industry. Johnny runs the top FM station, publishes music, and owns the ultra-hip Club Coconut.
I think my father being very famous in Trinidad, it's a plus, but it's always difficult to be judged by his standards. You always try and live up to his expectations and the way how people perceive him. But I think that if I'm able to accomplish, I always say to myself, if I'm able to accomplish 50% of what he has accomplished in terms of humility and the respect that he has from people, I would have done a good job.
Thank you.
become a little bit more aggressive in the business world, and as a result of being more aggressive, you know, not everybody is gonna like you as much. I'm a Trinidadian Chinese. I think that I'm very patriotic towards my country, Trinidad. And yes, I'm Chinese, but I'm Trinidadian Chinese.
Yeah, but my face is burnt.
Well, I think that one day I may go come full circle, and one day I may return to the restaurant business. But it's not an easy business. It's a very hard business. So you have to really make up your mind to go back into the food business.
However, it's Maurice Soong's eldest daughter, my new friend Anna, and her husband Johnny, who have taken over the day-to-day management of Soong's Great Wall.
It's very hard work, the restaurant work. It's round-the-clock work. But I've seen my parents do it, and if they can do it, I think we could do it, because we are the young blood now, and we can make them proud of us, because this restaurant is like a baby to my parents, especially my dad. And as he is, as you say, close to semi-retirement, I don't think he would ever retire, but he is a little bit laid back now, and he wants us to follow in his footsteps. So we are the ones to make them proud, and we will definitely try to do so.
Well, Mr. Soong worked so hard to bring it to where it is.
And I think we're the ones to maintain that standard.
We did not go through that, bringing it from scratch.
Yeah. You He's know, laid
we,
the
we
foundation.
We have been laid into a well-laid-out restaurant, well-organized, and basically we have to learn the organization as how he has set it out. So basically our jobs have pretty much been done for us, and it will be very difficult. One of the reasons is the cooks are Chinese, and they don't speak much English, and I don't speak any Chinese, so communication between the cooks and myself are difficult. So that's one hurdle that I will have to overcome in future sometime.
Maurice is legendary. He has dined with Hollywood stars, entertained Miss Universe contestants, and danced with the Prime Minister's wife. The restaurant has become the place to see and be seen. When I ask Trinidadians living in other countries about the best restaurant on the island, they always say, "Go to Soong's Great Wall."
I'm a Chinese, but I came here young. I did 12 years of age. So So I naturalized Trinidad. So I am a Trinidadian now.
We don't eat Trinidad.
Yeah.
I want. 我想要佢落葉歸根的時候，我係砌Trinidad。